Hello, I'm Greg Hollows, and welcome to the Imaging Lab. This is Contrast in Depth. Contrast is a really important concept to understand, and it's directly linked to resolution. And they go hand in hand. You cannot separate them at all, because you could have two lenses and systems specified at the same resolution. But if one has 40% contrast and one has 15% contrast, you're going to get wildly different results in the images that you obtain and the sort of analysis that you can do. So let's start with kind of a more larger scale application, not at fine resolution level, but it's something that's very large in an image, and get to understand what contrast really means. In the example that you see here, these are gel capsules. There are four pills in the shot, and they are designed to, two of them, to knock you out when you have a flu or a cold or something like that and let you feel better and get a good night's sleep. The other two are actually designed to be non-drowsy. The importance of that is that you don't want to mix them up when they're going into the bottles. You don't want somebody driving a forklift getting the ones that make you drowsy when they're not feeling well. So contrast is of critical importance. As we look with this camera here, this monochrome camera in the left-hand image, you'll see that the pills do look a little bit different. If you look at the graphical information below them, you'll see that there is actually a contrast difference of about 10%. Now, subtle variations in the lighting over time or any outside object that might be adding light to the system will throw the ability to separate those two pieces of information off and might either give you false positives or false negatives, both of which are bad for an imaging system. Now, in this example, what we did is use a color filter to enhance the contrast levels to much higher levels. And you can see if we use a red filter, the red pills actually end up going to be a light color and the green pills stay dark. Conversely, when we use a green filter, we get the opposite effect, both of which give us high levels of contrast and make this a very robust application all of a sudden. Now let's take it a step further though. There are a variety of things that go on in optics that allow us to get different levels of contrast. And what you really want to do in almost all applications is get a lens system that's going to get you the highest level of contrast at the resolution that's of interest to you. Now that could be a resolution like the pills, it's very large, or it could be something that's small, almost down to pixel limited detail, and maximizing contrast is usually going to get you the best results possible. Really what happens is if you look in the example that's up on the slide now, we have two spots. They're easily resolvable when they're far apart. The problem is when they get too close together in this example, as you can see, they start to blend together. You get constructive interference in the system. Now this could be down to some sort of pixel limited level where we actually have one or two pixels between them, but the lens system is actually getting too much interference between the two spots and they blur out and we get lack of focus. That trough that you see between them, as that continues to get less and less, that's our contrast level and things start to go down. One of the critical things to understand is that cameras have a noise floor to them, usually around 8 to 10% noise. Some are lower, some are higher. It depends on the design of the sensor, the camera electronics. But one thing that we have to keep in mind is when you get below that level of contrast or even close to it, generally getting repeatable results can be difficult at the resolution that you want. You always want to get the contrast levels of the lens in the 20-30% range if possible. If you get down to 10-5%, you're probably not going to see the detail that you want in the system. Additionally, other things in the system that can inherently bring noise into it, the cables, the capture boards, monitors, whatever else it may be, will also do some amount of degradation to the signal, and that can bring about problems if you're dancing on the edge of the resolution and contrast that you want. So let's take this another step. In the resolution section, you'll have noticed that we looked at certain types of targets. They had variable frequencies on them and made it very easy to see what was going on across a wide range of resolution. What I want to do now is take a much more straightforward look at one of these targets and use the same resolution across the entire field of view, and this is by using something called a Ronchi ruling. A Ronchi ruling, as you can see in the example here, is a set of lines, and we do some close-ups for you for the middle, bottom edge, and the corner. And what it is lines running across the entire field, so we can see how at a given resolution, a lens responds across the field of view with the specific camera that it's on. What we want to do is look at two different lenses and get the information about the contrast level that's actually produced at a given resolution. Both the lenses that are going to be used can reproduce the resolution of the Ronchi ruling onto the sensor. At this point, it's about 1/4 the resolution that's the limit of the camera. So basically 4 pixels on each black line and 4 pixels on each white line. As we look at example one, we're going to see nice robust levels of contrast at all these different positions in the 50s and 60s and even up a little bit higher. As we look at the second example, you're going to notice that we get down into the 20s, a very, very different level of contrast. And this is a way to let you relate the ability to see the detailed lines to the grayscale levels that are actually shown on the screen. Now, while both of these may be able to do many applications, one is going to be able to do it much more reliably than the other. Again, in both of these examples, all the specifications of these lenses are identical, except for their ability to reproduce contrast at given resolutions. So it's very important to think about contrast levels and not just the resolution that you need in the system when you're choosing the right optics. In future more advanced topics talking about MTF, we'll see how we can relate resolution and contrast together into a graphical piece of information that allows you to compare lenses pretty straightforwardly and at the same position for each lens and make the right choices for your particular application. That was contrast in depth. Next, we're going to do a detailed look at depth of field. You can also click any of the links on the screen for the area that is of most interest to you.